Wait.
Mistake. Names are powerful seals. The storm, damn it.
Here's the spot.
Chose a lovely spot.
Damn it, will you relent? I'm plowing now I've done wrong.
Good. The grave's dug up and empty.
What's that mean?
Botchling's on the prowl.
Look! It'll bite us in the arse before we know it.
Keep screaming and it will turn rabid. It's calm for now.
Bloody hell. What happens when it gets plowed and restless?
It'll bite through your jugular and you'll bleed to death before I can help. Tell me if it starts wriggling. I'll calm it with magic. Pick it up. Take it in your arms.
Merciful gods!
Back to the fortress.
What? With this?
As I recall, you were the one wanted to test the old legends, change it into a lubricant.
Oh, fuck.
I have to say, this shit is real gross.
What do you want to do with it?
Me? Nothing. This is your job. Told you, gotta bury it under the threshold. If the tales are true, by tomorrow it'll be a lubricant. From then on, it'll watch over your house and help me find your founder.
Hurry.
Forgive me, you who came, but who I did not embrace.
Forgive me, you who came, but whom I did not embrace.
I name thee, say her name, and embrace thee as my daughter.
I name thee, Daya, and embrace thee as my daughter. Now.
In one day's time, Daya should turn into a lubberkin. I'll stay here and wait. You go home.
I'll wait with you.
Out of the question.
But that's my child. The guilt, the responsibility for all this lies with me.
Time for parental impulses? It's long past. Besides, nothing else you can do here.
But...
No buts. Just Witcher's work left to do here. Gotta wait a day and a night for the botchling to turn into a lubberkin. That's it. Go home. And try not to drink yourself stupid again.
Blood's power, I summon you. With your name, I beseech you. Hear my call and arise, Daya. Lead me to those bound to you by blood.
Sure wasn't lavender they kept in there. Might be worth looking around, though. change in here. Shoe. No way a pitch burner could afford a horse. A bracelet. One of them must have dropped it. Both were here. I'm going the right way. Wants to show me something more. What do we have here? Bones have been here a while. Chewed on the saddle. Necrophages will eat anything these days. Giant claws. Wasn't a necrophage made these marks. Horseshoes missing. Is this the animal that lost one in the smokehouse? Torn clear off. Takes incredible strength. Must have been attacked by a powerful beast. Surprised him. Hope they got away. Trail goes on. Good thing it doesn't end here.
Now, you piece of filth.
A fisherman's hut. Seems she wants me to take a closer look.
what you seek here, sir? Our hut's out of the way. Woeful. He has nothing. We knows nothing.
Just need information. Looking for two women, the Bloody Baron's wife and daughter.
Not a soul have been here, sir.
Sure? Not even passing through? Daughter's medium height, about 20. Her mother's thin, about 40. Seen them?
That sir came at night, right, Mummy?
Quiet, boy!
I want to help that woman. She could be in danger.
Young'un see no one, my lord. He's a kiddie. Must have dreamt it.
I want to hear this dream, then. So, kid, who did you see? Who came here?
Pappy brought her at night. The lady does her medicines. She was all afeard. Talked about an awful monster. Said she had to go back. Don't know where to. Mummy and Pappy cheered her up. Gave her clothes. Hers were ragged.
Where'd the girl go? Your son said enough. No point in playing dumb anymore.
Sorry, sir. But you don't look like one of her father's men.
Because I'm not. I'm looking for Tamara and her mother. I need to know if they're alive and safe.
Tamara is high. She's to my brother's place in Oxenford. But Mrs. Atten, that's another tale. Though anywhere's better than the crow's perch with a baron.
Why?
Cause he beat her, sir. Beat Mrs. Anna, I mean. Everyone knew, but not a one lifted a finger for to stop it.
What happened to Tamara's mother?
For like this. I was awaiting in the old smokehouse with horses. Cold as hell and so dark, couldn't see past two elves in front of you. Moon had risen high, and still they hadn't come. Began to fear some demon had snatched him. But finally, they came forth, and he sets off towards the river. Suddenly, out of nowhere, a gale arose. Thought it'd tear my head off. And those damn birds, swarms of them coursing o'er the woods, raising a racket to make your ears bleed. Mrs. Anna screamed, bent over into herself. Tamara knelt down, gripped her arms. But then I saw it. Fiery marks.
Fine. What happened next?
Grew even darker. Seemed someone had put out the stars. Crickets all went silent of a sudden. And then, from the woods, a roar. Broke out in a cold sweat. And before I could catch my breath, a beast jumped out of the woods, big as a barn, with horns and two burning coals for eyes. I thought I was done for. Beast attacked Mrs. Anna's horse, ripped its head off. Carried her off into the woods. Our horses, mine and Miss Tamara's, got spooked and tore off willy-nilly. T'was the only reason we escaped. The miss wanted to go back for her mother, but my wife pleaded, said she'd die out there alone. Miss Tamara agreed not to go.
What marks?
These, well, like burned on with hot iron. On the palms, inside.
Burned? Like a cattle brand?
Aye, though these wasn't black scars scabbed over. It's hot and glowing, as if they burned with raw fire.
Why help them at all? You risked a lot.
By the debt. Owed Miss Tamara. 3 moons passed, a fever gripped my boy. We thought he was done for. Tamara alerted. Brought food and salves. We're poorer than dirt itself. She saved my boy. No two ways about it. Me, myself, I'd have never dared to help. But my missus told me a time of war and contempt's come, a time of folk gone wrong. We needs to repay good with good. Who stands by idly does evil as if.
Married a wise woman.
Crying shame we couldn't save Mrs. Anna in the end.
Thanks for your help.
The lady, she'll be all right in the end, won't she?
I'll do what I can to see that she is.
paths diverge. Thank you, Dea. Go in peace.